excited.
Why don't you start?
Okay, you know, 1997, when I first learned about Detroit's hockey IQ, it was where I saw the biggest man in the league and one of the best players, Eric Lindros. He got beat by one of the smaller guys, Larry Onoff. He got beat by guys that learned what positioning was, what good sticks were, what defensive posture was. Detroit loves to play with the puck. Why? Because it's offense, and they work harder than anybody to get the puck back when they don't have it. So a good example tonight. Let's take a look at Detroit. Hey, they're not as skilled as Chicago, but they work hard to get the puck back. Here's an example. Lose sight of the puck, cut the ice in half, okay? Make sure that there's no way you can get through the zone. Puck goes the other way, behind the net, and it goes to the other side. Let's do the same thing on this side. They work as a collective unit of five all the time. It's not one against the world like we're seeing from Chicago. They move up the ice as five. They move back as five. They've got great sticks. They are the kings of three-foot passes. It is incredible to watch their ability to move the puck up the ice. That's real speed. And if we can get off of this, that would be kind of nice. You're boring me to death, Glenn. There's a three-foot pass. There's good sticks.
You can hear me?
Oh, shut up. there's some more. Hard work by Datsyuk. Get your body in the way. This is a guy, Corey Emerton. Does he even know what Datsyuk's all about? Yeah, that's the way Datsyuk played. So when you don't have the puck, work your tail to get it off. And they learn from the best guy in the world, the most complete player, Pavel Datsyuk.